I'll show you how I made this scene in Blender 4.3. And yes, this monster is drawn with Grease Pencil. Grease Pencil is a 2D drawing and animation tool inside of Blender that now also lets you draw 3D strokes and objects. Since Grease Pencil keyframes can have different data every frame, it is also now a great tool to make clay-like animations. This workflow is a little bit different from regular drawing. First, I added a new Grease Pencil object. Also a 3D object to the scene, so I could tweak the 3D material easier. And added a Geometry Nodes tab. I added a new node tree for the Grease Pencil object. This setup converts your drawing data to mesh, then to a volume, and back to mesh. I switched to draw mode and started to form this blob shape first. When stroke placement is on the surface, I could draw more of a 3D shape. Then I used the eraser tool set to points to carve eyes and the mouth. For the vines, I added a new layer, duplicated the pumpkin material and made it green, duplicated the geonode setup and connected it like this. I added selection nodes for the layers, so I could define what layer uses what 3D material. I could also change the settings for the conversion. Animating with Grease Pencil is a lot easier if you use the same set of points, so I duplicated the existing keyframe and sculpted the pumpkin part to a ball-like shape. I also duplicated keyframes for the talking part that I sculpted to get the right mouse shapes. Then I interpolated between these keyframes in edit mode to get the animation going with a little bit smooth added. For the walking animation, I added a lattice object that covered the whole object. I added hooks to these points so I could move them using empties. I animated the monster to take a few steps and hang around here. Then I made the scene to support the movement. This is made with the Botanic addon. Fog is simple principle volume object. Camera has a Shakeify addon set to investigation. Everything is rendered in DV Next with ray tracing enabled. Watch this tutorial next to learn more about turning Grease Pencil strokes to 3D, or how to make Grease Pencil objects cast shadows. See you next time.